Why would anybody automate their mute button like this? Because who doesn't love to have their buttons pushed? Cush after hours. Coming at you. All right. Let's pull it down here and talk about the mixer's best friend. And I'm talking about the mute button. Even if all you ever do is mix your own music, I strongly encourage you to explore the use of automating mutes, because there are going to be moments in time when, for whatever reason, this sound that you thought worked perfectly across this transition, or things are just a little too cluttered, or a little too static, or there's not enough dynamic or growth. And the mute button is your best friend here. And I say mute button because I'm a little old school, will cut my teeth on analog console and tapes. But you can always slice a waveform and mute out the region or the clip. The net effect here is the idea that you up the game of the arrangement as a mixer. You choose when some things come and go that are not necessarily fully respecting the original composition. And you do this not necessarily in ways that draw attention to themselves, but are more about creating either energy vacuums or energy ramps. And when I say energy vacuum, what I mean is that one of the most common tricks in dance music that's been around forever is the bass drop. And I'm not talking about boo, that kind of bass drop. I'm talking about a beat or a measure before a new section hits. You just mute the bass, just kill the low end. And even if it's just for a beat, you get this boo, doo, doo, boo, doo, boo, boo, and then it hits on the one, and everybody feels that. And it has a couple of effects. Number one, it creates that vacuum. And it's not just with bass, you can do this with anything, but with bass in particular, it creates a very palpable vacuum. People don't generally listen to bass, but they're always feeling it. It's a strong emotional component of a mix. And when you take it away from them, even for just a, people feel that, and it creates this sort of lift in the space, and then you give it back to them, and you've done several things there. You've increased the contrast of the moment, which engages the listener's brain and grabs their attention, which is always a good thing to do. And you kind of refocus the energy of the song in that moment, which is a really powerful thing to do. And also, for people who weren't listening to the bass, you may key them into the low end and what the low end is doing there and create a bass fan for life. So use the mute button. Use it on bass, but use it on other things too. A lot of times, I'll mute a vocal. I will mute backing vocals because they wrote a harmony across this whole section, and I'm like, yeah, but nothing else is changing, and I got 8 bars of music here, so what if we held back this harmony for the second half of the verse? Or what if the harmony came in with the vocal for just the first phrase, then I mute it out, and then when we get into the next to the last phrase, I bring it back. So experiment, play around with these things. This is one of the reasons why it's fun to have a little control surface where you just hit a button and it mutes out whatever you're doing, and then you go into an automation mode and just play around with what happens. If you have any ideas that I didn't hit in this, please hit us up in the comments below. Leave your feedback, give us some likes, do what you do. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Gregory Scott. This has been Kush After Hours. Till next time.